James Thurston Neighbors, June 12, 1930, November 30, 2017, was an American actor, singer, and comedian. Neighbors was born and raised in Sylacauga, Alabama, but he moved to Southern California because of his asthma. He was discovered by Andy Griffith while working at a Santa Monica nightclub, and he later joined The Andy Griffith Show as Gomer Pyle. The character proved popular, and Neighbors was given his own spin-off show Gomer Pyle, USMC. Neighbors was known for his portrayal of Gomer Pyle, although he became a popular guest on variety shows which showcased his rich baritone voice in the 1960s and 1970s, including two specials of his own in 1969 and 1974. He subsequently recorded numerous albums and singles, most of them containing romantic ballads. Neighbors was also known for singing Back Home Again in Indiana prior to the start of the Indianapolis 500, held annually over the Memorial Day weekend. He sang the unofficial Indiana anthem almost every year from 1972 until his final time performing the song in 2014, except for occasional absences due to illness or scheduling conflicts. Neighbors was born on June 12, 1930 to Mavis and Fred Neighbors in Sylacauga, Alabama, where he sang for his high school and church, and he had two sisters. He attended the University of Alabama, where he began acting in skits. While at Alabama, he became a member of Delta Tau Delta International Fraternity. After graduating, he moved to New York City, where he worked as a typist for the United Nations. After a year, he moved to Chattanooga, Tennessee, where he got his first job in the television industry as a film cutter. Because of his asthma, Neighbors moved to Los Angeles and worked as a film cutter for NBC. He also worked at a Santa Monica tavern, The Horn, singing and acting in cabaret theater. His act featured him as a character similar to the Gomer Pyle character he later portrayed. He sang in a baritone and sometimes spoke and sang in his higher-pitched comedic voice. At the club, comedian Bill Dana saw Neighbors' act and invited him to appear on The Steve Allen Show. Neighbors signed on to the show, but it was soon cancelled. Neighbors began vacationing in Hawaii in the 1960s, and in 1976, moved from Bel Air, California, to Honolulu, Hawaii. For 25 years, he owned a macadamia plantation on Maui before selling it to the National Tropical Botanical Garden, a conservationist organization, though he still retained farming rights to the land and owned a second home on the property. Neighbors married his partner of 38 years, Stan Cadwallader, at Seattle, Washington's Fairmont Olympic Hotel on January 15, 2013, a month after same-sex marriage became legal in Washington. Although he had been closeted before this, his sexual orientation was not completely secret. For instance, Neighbors brought his then-boyfriend Cadwallader along to his Indy 500 performance in 1978. A long-standing rumor maintains that Neighbors married Rock Hudson in the early 1970s, shortly before Neighbors began his relationship with Cadwallader. Not only was same-sex marriage not yet legal in any U.S. state at the time, at least publicly, the two were never more than friends. According to Hudson, the story originated with a group of middle-aged homosexuals who live in Huntington Beach, who sent out joke invitations for their annual get-together. One year, the group invited its members to witness the marriage of Rock Hudson and Jim Neighbors, at which Hudson would take the surname of Neighbors' most famous character, Gomer Pyle, becoming Rock Pyle. The rumor was spread by those who failed to get the joke, and because Neighbors was still closeted at the time and Hudson never publicly admitted to being gay, despite widespread suspicion that he was, the two never spoke to each other again. Neighbors died at his Honolulu, Hawaii, home on November 30, 2017. Aged 87. At the time of his death, Neighbors was suffering from health issues regarding his immune system as a result of contracting hepatitis B in India. The United States Marine Corps released a statement on Neighbors, Semper Fi, Gomer Pyle. Rest in peace, Jim Neighbors, one of the few to ever been named an honorary Marine. Second Lady of the United States and former First Lady of Indiana Karen Pence wrote a statement on Twitter, so sad to hear about the passing of Jim Neighbors. We heard him sing Back Home Again in Indiana at the Indianapolis 500 countless times. We will miss his beautiful voice. In an interview with The Hollywood Reporter, Carol Burnett paid tribute to Neighbors saying they were close friends for 52 years. My heart is heavy. I'm grateful he was a large part of my life. I miss him. I love him. IndyCar legend Tony Kanaan praised Neighbors' performance of Back Home Again in Indiana. Journalist Larry King praised Neighbors as a gentleman with immense talent while sending condolences to his husband Stan and family.